This is a short little video on how to install radiant barrier into a wall assembly, on basically how to keep the heat out, more of a hot weather or a summer type application. We get a lot of customers calling and they're doing a remodel, they're tearing out some walls, they've got their studs open, they've got their exterior sheathing, and they want to know whether or not they can install a radiant barrier on that west or south facing wall to help reduce the heat coming in. And the answer is yes, but the first thing you have to do in order to do this is create an airspace. You have to have an airspace for a radiant barrier to exist. Normally what happens if you stuff this bay full of insulation, the exterior sheathing gets hot and it just travels, the heat travels by conduction all the way through the insulation and into the house. When you create this airspace and you put the radiant barrier foil right there, what's going to happen is the exterior is going to get hot. It's going to want to conduct across, but when it hits this airspace, in order to get across that airspace, it mostly has to convert to radiant. And once heat is in a radiant form, it's great because we own it. We can just reflect it back. What that does is keep the insulation right here cooler, and that drives less heat into the home. So the insulation is more effective, basically. It's almost like adding more insulation is the net effect. Now, if you're doing a remodel and you really want to do it, the way you do it is you're going to put some foam strips in, then you're going to staple your foil up. So the foil is going to go basically right up against the wall, either half inch or 3/4 inch foam boards. You can just staple in there, pull it across, staple on the other side, put your bad insulation in, and then this is an optional layer. This is half inch blue board or foam board, blue, pink, it doesn't really matter. But what it does is it gives more R value to the wall, but it also makes the wall airtight and it reduces what's called thermal bypass. Basically, this is heat coming through the stud that would go into the house. It's kind of like putting a jacket on that wall. And then ultimately drywall or sheetrock. So coming from the outside in, you've got your exterior sheathing, you've got your airspace made up by your foam furring strips, you've got your insulation, optional foam board, and then sheetrock. Now if you do the foam board and the sheetrock, one thing you want to do is offset all the pieces so you don't have two seams on one location. You don't want to have a foam seam right next or right on top of a sheetrock seam. But really that's about it. It's an easy install, it's cheap, it works great. You're gonna notice this wall is a lot cooler, a lot less heat's coming through, the room's gonna be a lot more comfortable and energy efficient. For more information, visit atticfoil.com or warehousefoil.com.